one of two protocols will be used at layer 4 of the OSI model to encapsulate the data coming from layers 5, 6, and 7. TCP, Transmission Control Protocol Segments, or UDP, User Datagram Protocol Datagrams, will be selected by an application that's sending data. TCP establishes a connection between the source and destination devices for reliable data transfer and flow control, sending data at an acceptable rate both to the source and destination. UDP is connectionless and has no flow control. All bytes sent with TCP are ordered and sequenced. TCP guarantees that every single byte sent will be received with integrity and processed in the correct order. So actually, there are, in fact, three things that are guaranteed in life: death, taxes, and TCP. TCP segments are acknowledged, so the sender knows the destination got the traffic. If an acknowledgement, specifically referencing byte numbers of the data sent, doesn't come back, TCP resends the unacknowledged bytes. UDP doesn't do this. So which one is better? Well, it depends. TCP is used for things like file transfers, email, and going to websites. In those cases, accuracy is important. If bytes are lost or corrupted, the whole message could be destroyed. UDP is used for real-time communications, conferencing, and streaming. Furthermore, two major protocols coming up in a future module, DNS and DHCP, both use UDP. If every byte sent needed to be acknowledged on a VoIP call over the web, there could be problems with lost acknowledgments. TCP on the source would think the destination didn't get the message and would resend it again. So the destination would hear "hello" and send its acknowledgement back to the source. Let's say that the acknowledgement got lost. The destination would hear the subsequent words from the voice call that were already sent by the source: "How are you doing today?" But then the source would send "hello" back again. That would be a very frustrating phone call. You'd have the past coming back into the current conversation. You'd have to imagine, though, that all audio and video, real-time and streaming over the internet in UDP datagrams, still has to be ordered to ensure they're processed in the correct order. RTSP, Real-Time Streaming Protocol, which exists at layer 7, does the ordering for UDP. Using RTSP, just for the ordering of the UDP datagrams, involves significantly less overhead than TCP would require. If TCP was used, a connection would have to be established and maintained, flow control would need to be added, and acknowledgments would need to be sent. The communication could slow down based on these and other factors. With UDP, if bytes are lost, we don't care. They're just a fleeting moment in time. You might not even notice. One might notice a slight degradation in image quality or sound quality. But even if that's the case, we just accept it instead of slowing down the entire communication for the additional overhead that TCP requires. TCP has much more overhead than UDP and is deliberately slower, striving for accuracy and integrity. UDP has no overhead and is quicker, striving for efficiency. When querying your DNS server to resolve a name to an IP address, or your DHCP server to get or renew a lease for an IP address, if no reply comes back to the client, your client will simply ask again. There's no need for additional overhead.